We've got EJ here, and of course Mark Eaton, who's been on before, former jazz player, and Doug Dalton, the local, who is also a patient of EJ's. Mm-hmm. And we're here talking about, last week we talked a little about your health team, and chiropractic obviously should be a big part of that. And Mark, you're a huge proponent, that was no pun intended, I'm sorry.
I am, that's okay.
A proponent of chiropractics. But tell me why you think, I don't want to ask EJ because he's not very objective about it, but why you think
you mean?
It should be a big part of your health team.
Well, I think that chiropractic offers some quicker solutions and some different solutions than traditional allopathic care. And I've been a proponent of chiropractic since my father first took me to one when I was about 6 years old. And as an NBA player, it saved me. The fact that we had a team chiropractor and someone who could do some very specialized work with us got me back from injuries very quickly, and I could come back from a pulled muscle or something within a couple of days, as opposed to traditional care, which would have been weeks of ice and therapy and other things.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's part of my wellness program continually, and even after being out of basketball for 14 years now, as I passed the 50 mark, you become much more concerned about your health and wellness and what can I do proactively to take care of myself, and chiropractic has played a major role in that.
Well, and I even said that you look like you got a little taller since I saw you last, which of course EJ wanted to take credit for that.
Right. So he's worked out some of the kinks.
Right. Doug, we wanted to have you on too because, of course, you know, people see Mark and say, well, he's a former athlete, chiropractic. Maybe that's something that athletes should be concerned about. But tell me about your experience with chiropractic and EJ's service.
Well, you mentioned the 50 mark. I thought it was a 30 mark.
Right. I was going to say 40.
Now I'm heading towards the 40 mark, so yeah. I really see it as a holistic approach, and really looking at it as, you know, preventative care, like Mark said, but really trying to get out of the sick care system and into the healthcare system, which is, you know, planning ahead and working towards wellness. So really through diet, exercise, good intention, and, you know, doing the right things, I think you can keep your immune systems up, you can keep your, you know, body systems up, and really just enjoy life more. It's about kind of connecting with your body rather than kind of just sitting outside of it and hoping everything goes well.
And one of the biggest keys, and it kind of goes in line with that, is really just an overall proactive approach. I like that, getting out of the sick care and into the health care. But that's really what it's about, EJ. Isn't it more about, you know, rather than waiting for something to hit you, mm-hmm. getting, you know, being proactive with all parts, whether it's mentally, physically, spiritually, whatever that may be. But that's the huge proponent there, key, isn't it?
Absolutely. Seems like so much of, I don't know, our upbringing and society and commercials and whatever try and push us into the passage seat, you know, into the along for the ride position, when I think we need to be there at the steering wheel deciding where we go and how we go and what it is we want and go for it. And so I love to hear these guys talk about their experience, because I think that's available to all of us.
Mm-hmm.
As we find the healthcare team that fits us, that works for us, we can have more.
Well, even when you go to traditional MD, after the crisis is over and you pass the sickness, many of them will say, well, you know, why don't you start taking some vitamins? Why don't you start doing some things to take better care of yourself? Here's an opportunity to do that.
Right, but they don't really want you to do that. The typical doctors, they want you to go back, get sick again, come back and see them again. They don't want you to go on and take advantage of that. No, I'm just kidding. But EJ, let me ask you though,
sure.
Why, speaking specifically again about chiropractors, why do you suppose a lot of folks are maybe a little bit unsure about going to a chiropractor? They're just, you know, they're maybe a little hesitant.
Well, I think it's definitely just outside the norm enough that, you know, it's not kind of like that everybody goes type thing. Mm-hmm. And then, I don't know, some people, because it's not the mainstream maybe, someone's gone and had a bad experience, and so one chiropractor did this and that changes the whole, you know, in reality there's dentists out there that aren't great, there's medical doctors, and so I think we want to stay more open rather than say, oh, this is my, I've made a decision, this is the way it is, and mm-hmm. I'll never see a medical doctor again, or I'll never see a chiropractor again. I think say, where can I benefit, what can they bring to the table for me, what can I drive and get, and it's not an exclusive thing. We find the fit and we benefit and we gain from, and then mm-hmm. we continue to you know, evolve and get what we're after.
Well, and I think EJ, you've said this before, and I say this a lot, you can't use the past to judge a current experience.
Excellent. Mm-hmm.
So regardless of what's occurred in the past, when you go into a new experience, you have to look at it for what it is. Can this benefit me? Can this help me? Let's give it a try, rather than saying, well, that didn't, you know, I tried that once before, it didn't work. Well, that doesn't mean something new is not going to work right now.
Right, right. It, so often, as you mentioned, depends on who you're seeing. And one of the things that I know EJ is praised about by, you know, all of his patients is the fact that he does take a holistic approach to all of, you know, his patients. And it's just, you know, it's about your diet. It's about so many things. But if somebody was thinking about coming to see you, you know, does insurance sometimes help out with these things?
See, that's a great question. I think it's a question very common, but I don't think it's relevant. In that insurance is important, and I want insurance to pay, but more important than your $15 copay is your health,
mm-hmm.
right?
That's
and sometimes
point.
We're like,
yeah.
well, my copay, does it cover?
Mm-hmm.
Who cares?
Yeah.
If it gets you what you want, you're worth it. Insurance sometimes will cover, sometimes it won't cover chiropractic. Again, it's not as important as you getting the results you want. If insurance will help out, awesome. If not, who cares? Again, it doesn't pay for the gym, it doesn't pay for the healthy
yeah.
food. You go
and that's
you want
that's a
you
great
want.
Point. And so often concern when you're going to see a typical doctor is the uncertainty. How much is it going to cost?
Mm-hmm.
You know, if they put me in to do some test, it could be thousands of dollars. Whereas, you know, if somebody's on a regular schedule with you, you could compare it to a gym membership maybe that's not being used or something like
exactly.
that. And it would be comparable, wouldn't it?
We're $40 a visit.
Mm-hmm.
We're worth $400 a visit. We're $40. It's not, you know what I mean? It's not
yeah.
a big amount of money. Your copay sometimes is as much as my office visit is.
Right.
So it works out great. Again, the bigger thing is finding that fit and getting what you want and what you deserve, and I say go for it.
Yeah. Doug, what would you say has been the biggest benefit for you when you're factoring in chiropractic into your life?
Well, you know, as an athlete and kind of living in this healthy town, a lot of people will say, well, there's nothing wrong with me. Why should I go in there? And, you know, I can equate it to some of the other things like, you know, eating organic vegetables. You're aiming for a higher level throughout your life. And so, you know, if it is $40 here or if it's, you know, whatever it is, I'm not content to live at 80%. I want to live at, you know, 110%. And it goes, and it really kind of transcends throughout basically your whole day, your whole life, whether it's relationships, whether it is your performance at the office, or for me, whether it's having more fun on my bike or, mm-hmm. you know, really whatever it is. And so I would say just to be there and to really concentrate on what you're doing and try and take your everyday, you know, 80 or 90% working great life to 100% and
yeah.
really feeling better about everything. And it really does. It goes through everything.
And isn't it so true? I mean, I know that for me and my family, that's the reason, one of the big reasons why we moved here is because of people who have that desire for their life to not settle for that, you know, 70, 80, 90%, but really want more from their life. So.
Yeah, and I think it goes all the way through. If you want to live at a 10, you know, you're going to allocate your resources to make that happen. You decide, okay, I'm going to move to Park City because I want to live at a 10 level.
Mm-hmm.
And so you shifted and adjusted things to make that happen. And it's the same thing. I'm going to take care of my body. You'll find that your habit patterns will change once you make that commitment and that everything else will fall in line.
Absolutely. All right, well, EJ, people want to get a hold of you. How do they do it?
They can catch us at 655-7789. We're there in New Park, or they can catch us on the web at healthyparkcity.com. And be happy to provide any information we can to help them out.
And I'm sure they can come in and get a consultation, meet with you.
Yeah,
and
we're always, the thing is when you sit down, if initially I don't feel like this is the right place, I'm going to tell you that, and there's not going to be a charge.
Right.
If we start to say, hey, this is something I feel comfortable with, we've seen this, I think we can really help you make some improvement, let's go to work, and if this fits, we'll continue to work. If it doesn't fit, then you can start to find other resources and get that tan you deserve.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's in there, but it's really easy to settle. Man, I feel great. I'm
yep.
80 and it's awesome.
There you go.
That's
absolutely. Well, Mark, EJ, Doug, thanks so much for being here with us. We'll look forward to having you back again next week and look forward to seeing you at Freebo's performance.
Yes.
All right. Stay with us. We got lots more coming up on the Mountain Morning Show right after this.